also here.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the Mulligan family reunion. I see there are some new members to the family this year, so thank you for making it to the reunion this year. But just as some introductions, I'm Nathan Mulligan.
I'm Greg Mulligan.
I'm Ginger Mulligan.
I'm Becca Mulligan.
I'm Anitra Mulligan.
And since some of you are, in fact, new to the family, we'll explain what we do at the talent portion of the reunion. So we're going to do some improv. We're going to get a suggestion from you guys. We're going to talk about the suggestion a little bit. And from that conversation, it's going to inspire some improv scenes. So, social media.
Yeah. Like, we love when you guys buy tickets, but you can also support us for free by liking us on social media and reviewing us and liking our posts and all of that stuff. It's free.
Yeah.
What about Uncle Jerry?
Uncle Jerry isn't here. Apologies. Yeah. Uncle Jerry could not make it this year. He was detained in Cuba. Yeah, again, but you know, he loves his cigars, you know, so, but to kick this off, what's something legitimately good that's been happening in your life in the last year or so?
That was a best. Oh, you're having to dig deep.
Yeah. I'm not sure what was worse, the fact that nobody had anything, or they're like, oh.
We had a baby.
What?
Okay.
So it's 8 months old, but like it's yeah. It always is weird to me that because it's not 9 months-ish when it's born, right? Why does it reset at that point?
Oh, why are we not all 9 months? Why do we not all just say that we're 9 months old then?
Right. I never
So do you want to celebrate your conception day? Is that what you're saying?
Well, I think that that's not no one
right. But I'm just saying, how are you marking?
You just mark your born.
You just add 9 months,
right? So I just think it's, weird.
It'd be weirder if you celebrated your conception.
Well, no, nobody wants that idea.
Yeah, but now you've clearly established that you marked a day that is 9 months before your birth.
Yeah.
That's your conception.
I'm not
literally.
You don't even know that that's the exact day. You're born, that's pretty obvious.
You guys are thinking of the planter, and I'm thinking of the seed. Okay.
The seed is what we're talking about.
No, the any fruit I'm gonna say is gonna go poorly.
Yeah.
So, was it a boy or a girl?
It's a boy.
Fantastic. Is it like you guys' first kid or? All right.
Yeah, he was actually conceived 2 years prior.
Wow, it's a long bake.
Okay.
This is a slow cooked baby.
You know, if anything worth doing well, you know what I mean? So, my wife is Nicaraguan, and when she was pregnant, I would shake her stomach, and she's like, what are you doing?
Dangerous.
Let me finish my story.
Yeah, it's gonna end fine.
It wasn't violently. I was just like a jiggle, and she was like, what are you doing? And she was
here, demonstrate.
Yeah, I was just like, right? And she would ask me what I was doing, and I was like, I'm gonna make sure the colors mix evenly. And it works. They have gorgeous olive skin tone.
Is that what? Okay.
That was a secret.
I did something wrong because my baby is white.
Yeah. Did you mix it?
No.
No. So then, not so crazy now, am I? Right.
Yeah.
Oh, and so it's your first kid, and it's a boy. It has a name, I assume, unless you're one of those like it can pick it and wants to.
No offense to anyone who might do that.
Yeah. The first thing that he grabs. That's his name.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, but Megatron would be a dope name. But,
yeah.
But as soon as...
His name is Grafton.
Grafton? That's different. Is there...
It's that ghost town.
Grafton, Utah.
Out by Sea Springer.
You named your son after a ghost town? That's amazing. B, why?
One of the little pieces of southern Utah. We have to be unique.
No, it's a great... No judgment. I think it's amazing.
Which is?
Shelby,
so
with a C and ending with an I.
Shelby with a C and ending with an I. Gotcha. So like Shelby.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's Shelby. Yeah. I would say that wrong if I read it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you at all concerned that you've invited possible ghosts into your house?
Yes.
That they're just gonna see the name Grafton in the ether and be like, oh, that's where we hang out now.
Right.
Are you concerned about it now?
Okay. Or like not even just haunted, like he's gonna inevitably be the vessel for like some angry minor spirit.
Ooh, yeah, like a
These are all things you guys had not thought of when you were picking this name. Yeah. Can we give them any other like existential terrors about their child?
I don't think it's a question of whether we can or whether we should.
Okay. I mean,
we could. Yeah,
we could. But we should.
It's like that Jurassic Park. They were so busy. Like, what is this quote? Thinking, trying. What is it? They were so busy saying, asking if we could, that no one stopped to ask if we should.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the way you said it.
Yeah. With the whole, like, what's the Jurassic part? Like, the whole lead in. Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense. Okay. Is there a middle and last name to Grafton? The future?
And, like, a social security number? What's your maiden name?
What's your mom's name?
Does he have one? Or is he going to be a
name? Okay. What was the name of your street that you grew up on? Did that be mom?
Your first
grade teacher.
Yeah.
No,
we're good.
I think so. I was legitimately curious.
I was pretty good when you were starting to shape your
okay.
Which I really hope it comes out next. I'm sorry. Congratulations.
Thank you. Squirrel water skiing tournaments.
Oh,
Spins the oven knob a couple of times, like full rotations. And just sees like where it lands, and then he
we'll have three of those.
Excellent. Very good. I'll just be going in. Did you want me to take back the waters?
We'll have three more.
Oh, all right, sounds good. I'll be right back with those.
I didn't order
three waters, and I was
Sure, I can take them back.
Sorry, can I get the specials, please?
Yeah, we have a Chilean sea bass that was found.
Okay.
And our chef, like, he just likes it to kind of occur naturally, so he'll put it in and close his eyes and he'll turn it up like three times.
I think instead I'll have the mac and cheese.
Okay, so cancel the three.
No, three? I will still eat the three Chilean sea bass.
You're going to eat three Chilean sea bass on your own?
It has been a long time since I have tasted the sweetness of food.
Okay, so three sea basses and a mac and cheese.
Yeah, yes, three sea basses and a mac and cheese. You say you haven't eaten for a while?
I had lunch.
And that's a long time for you?
No.
Do you... Are you malnutritioned or something? No, you don't look malnutritioned.
I missed my target, huh?
Your target? Oh, like you're trying to hit like a target weight? I'm so sorry. I did not even insinuate anything about your body type or your image. I was just taken aback at ordering three.
And what body type might that be?
This feels like a trap.
No, it's safe.
You're safe?
Safe!
Sorry, are you asking for the chef?
Safe! It's safe.
Oh, it's safe! Yeah. Oh, it's safe to tell you what body type you are?
So, the Chilean sea bass were actually down to just two, so...
So not three then?
Yes, just two.
Fine, great.
Great.
Are you
gonna be? Oh shoot!
Oh.
Okay, so you said two Chilean sea bass.
Yes.
Fine.
Yes.
Fine.
Two for you.
No, I don't want two. She wants two.
Yes, she.
Yes, she. She will have that.
Sorry. Sorry. Do you guys know each other? You're holding hands.
That is what we are all about, service at this friendly restaurant.
I'm a friendly woman.
Here. You would get better tips this way.
Honestly, I'm going in a couple different directions here. I know that I haven't... Okay, admittedly, I am pretty inexperienced. This is technically my first date that I've successfully been on this far.
I am the same.
Yeah, you said that earlier. I assume that this wasn't your first
date. It wasn't an arranged marriage. I said wasn't an arranged marriage.
Yeah.
The scenario between you, a man, and me, a woman.
A beautiful woman.
Oh, you old scum.
So tell me all about it. What is he like? What does he do?
Like, it started off really well. Like, it was great. But then, like, I don't know. About how he plays a pretend didgeridoo, and I was like, that's hot. He started asking me weird questions about what I eat.
Caitlin, I'm sorry, you lost me a didgeridoo. You really thought that was hot?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. No, that's fine. I guess it's online dating, so you just kind of skip it.
You get what you get.
Yeah. And then it got worse?
It was weird. And then he made me eat two sea bass.
Like, did he watch you eat them? Or like, he ate them with you? Or?
I mean, he was eating them.
So, bro, how was that date that you blew up didgeridoo practice for?
I'm, to be honest, I mean, like, I'm really glad that I finally have, you know, one in my pocket. You know, I have finally completed a first date.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Dude.
But boy, was it a...
You got past the hellos?
I got past the hellos.
My man.
Yeah.
All right.
It was, it was good, but like, it was weird, man. Like, you've been on a lot of dates, right?
No.
Cool.
Music's my only love.
You're right.
You were saying.
Yeah, no, just that, she ate a lot. Like, she ate two full fish.
How big were the fish, though?
Like a Chilean sea bass.
A Chilean sea bass are huge.
Yeah, they're enormous.
Of the various bass species that I know many things
it's
about.
It's one of the bigger bass.
Yeah. Like, if Jesus had had two Chilean sea basses,
that would have been shot.
You wouldn't have had,
to split them up.
You would have had the multitude. Yo, Big J, I got two Chilean sea bass.
Thank you.
Like your work.
Right? Even better.
Yeah.
You know what? Tell you what, I don't have any utensils to prepare this with, so let's just pass them around. Everyone take a bite. Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Everyone take a bite, and then...
Only if it's Chilean sea bass.
Yeah, that's...
Like, I wouldn't stick around for any kind of sermon for any kind of fish, so...
Yeah, I don't care how many lepers you've cured, but... Sea bass?
Yeah.
It's the best, man.
And that's how the story went in the Bible. But anyway, about your date.
It was weird. Like, she kept insinuating that, like, I was making her do it.
Okay.
And, like, I kept telling her, no, you don't have to eat them, but you ordered them. So, and then she kept, is that what gaslighting is?
Maybe.
Was I being gaslit?
Maybe it's a women thing, you know?
It's probably a women thing.
You know, because, women...
So, wait, you didn't order them? You no. Just, these are yours, Ina?
Yes.
That is gaslighting, Caitlin. Okay. You can't go on dates with people like that.
I thought it was romantic what the guy ordered for you.
Not if you don't remember it.
Do you know him? Yeah, he calls me.
So wait, you have a second date with her and the waiter?
Yeah, they were close. First off, this waiter is a character. Uh-huh. Let me tell you what.
Yeah, go ahead.
I will.
Okay.
This guy.
Uh-huh.
He's very forward.
He sounds handsome, whoever he is.
You know, he is. I will give him.
That's
that.
Just the energy I get.
He's a,
you know,
he's
I've
a
seen
handsome
him.
Guy.
But he just sounds like someone that's good looking and probably a skilled lover. But you were saying.
Yeah, 100%. By the way that he was interacting with Diane,
uh-huh.
An incredibly skilled lover.
Weird, man. Women really are from Venus and men from Mars, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what. I don't know. They were holding hands?
Okay.
Is that normal?
Depends on the restaurant, you know?
What? Did you do that at
the... Sorry. Guys, didgeridoo practice is over. Go home.
We signed up.
Yeah.
We signed the room out.
Yeah. We only had it for 30 minutes.
There's a list for a reason.
We're out of the top now.
You can...
But there's a weird part.
Wait. The didgeridoo is not the weirdest part. The two Chilean sea bass being casted is not weird. Okay, what happened? I'm so glad I'm here. This is ridiculous.
I also kind of hit it off with the waiter.
Look, what do you mean, kind of? Like, you like, looked at him, he winked at you, he gave you a freezy mass, or?
I don't know. It was like all of a sudden there was just a connection there.
A connection?
I don't know. All of a sudden we were just like holding hands. It was weird, but then I felt something.
Like, were you holding hands above the table or under the table? Did he see? Could he see that?
Yeah.
And he still wants to go out with it? That's really interesting. He must be super desperate. Not that you're like
I mean, I'm so desperate.
Yeah.
I just, you know, I will take anything. So I just gotta bite the bullet.
But it's the second day when you're the only one in the didgeridoo club that, you know,
doesn't have an actual didgeridoo.
Well, I was gonna say has gotten a second day. Yeah.
Are those correlated?
Nah.
Yeah, I mean, if I had a didgeridoo,
yeah,
I'd be getting third
dates. Yeah, dude, I would date you thrice like all the time if you had a didgeridoo.
Is that the only thing holding me back?
Yeah. I mean, I felt a spark, I'm not gonna lie. You know, because I'm a, you know, as an artist, I gotta explore my feelings, right? But I just, if you were dedicated to this craft, you would have. So I think it's a commitment thing. I feel like if you really, like, had some long-term potential in you, you would, like, get a mentor, you know? But since you just, you're always, like, you're not actually holding anything, I think that's like a metaphor that he wouldn't actually like hold me, like an emotional way, you know what I mean? So, but if you did have a didgeridoo, oh yeah. Whoa, hey, whoa! Don't just be grabbing my didgeridoo. I'm old fashioned, bro. That's like a fourth date kind of thing. But your forwardness.
I never actually had one in my hands before.
Feels good, right?
Feels real good.
Yeah.
Maybe this is why I'm so unlucky.
Maybe you should. Okay.
Maybe I've been didgeridooing the wrong thing.
Yeah. Okay, alright. This breaks didgeridoo code. But DL, I'm gonna loan you my didgeridoo for your second date.
I don't think I want to go on the second date anymore.
Have you considered that proposition with a didgeridoo in your hand?
Hi, Hope Red Lobster. Here is your silverware, here's your water, and here are your appetizers and cheddar bay biscuits. I'll be back.
See, now that...
Sorry about that, guys. Traffic was.
Okay, sorry, here's the silverware, water, appetizers, and cheddar bay biscuits.
It's not how I would have done it, but. Something's different about you.
Right?
Like, I was super hesitant to show up on this date. And I was like, you know, what else am I gonna do on a Thursday? But, like.
Okay, I have to ask. Will you
please
play it for us?
Wait, did he not actually have a thing in his hands last time? Oh, that's hot. Okay.
Just.
Yep.
Hi, do you guys want my answer?
No.
No?
I think we're full already.
That's weird.
No, I want a lobster.
How about two Chilean sea bass? Actually, we have three left in the kitchen. I'll be right back.
Nope. Service is so forward around here.
Howard? How? Yeah. I thought you were just, you know, you and me. I mean, last Thursday I came into the restaurant, you served me. I thought we were kind of exclusive. I mean, this has been going on for months.
Jennifer.
Yes. Our bodies are boiling in that pot.
Look,
we can on the plane of existence again.
Yes.
What? Can you?
How about those two?
He's got a ditch.
Oh, yes.
I shall take the one who prefers being gasoline. Why don't you take that
man? A man's got a ditch.
And something alluring to bald men.
The one who looks like a scaled lover.
Yes.
Don't
Don't go breaking my heart.
Don't try!
Yes. Yes, for us, people, we love to sing.
And we love people food.
Yes. We love people food, especially these sort of golden yellow rocks. I'm just going, wow, that is a lot of.
So wait, am I playing?
That's a lot of kisses. What?
You guys wanted me to play, or is that how? I'm not quite sure.
Yes, play.
Yes.
Play.
I'm just gonna go. Howard, don't expect a tip from me anymore.
Is that the later?
No, I don't think so. I think I'm the waiter. I feel like a waiter.
I feel like your waiter.
Sorry, are dating always this weird? I don't know, medium. Compare it to.
This is totally normal for people.
Very normal.
Weird people.
Also,
yep.
Is that the first time you've held that thing?
Yeah. No.
You don't look fully comfortable with it. I'm gonna be honest.
Well, this is like I've held it many times in my mind. You know, it's like the Sleeping Beauty of music. You know that like.
We're unfamiliar with that reference, even though we're regular people.
Never
heard of that thing.
Never.
It's like an early Disney movie in which she's like in love with this person, right? But she talks like she's met him in a dream, so she knows him because of the dream, but she has no actual like experience.
I'm sorry, our only pop culture references is the Don't Go Breaking My Heart song. That's the one thing. Its sound waves just naturally permeate the water. And just reached us.
That we swim in as adults.
Yeah, that's so crazy because, like, famously, most crabs love that song.
A crab? Oh, ridiculous. Or a lobster.
But anyway, I have no practical experience with a didgeridoo, but I played one in my heart a lot, if that makes sense.
Well, why don't you play for us now?
Yeah.
If you feel so confident.
That's weird.
Sorry, it's my first time with a tongue.
Oh.
No,
I've had many tongues. I've had so many tongues. Tongues for days.
Okay, tongue portion.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
All right.
Go ahead.
Sorry, you were about to play?
Yeah, you keep interrupting me.
Oh, sorry. Did I?
Well, I don't know, you just called me out.
Your grip is so tight. You got such a strong grip.
For a regular human. Right.
Yeah. Okay, well, I'm just going to play this.
Hank.
Who's Hank?
I mean, hello again.
Are you all right, Diane?
I'm fine. Play away.
All right.
Well, your grip's tight and lessened, like it's almost like a frail old woman is holding my hand now.
Hank, we have a problem.
Who's Hank?
Just play away.
Play away? Like you want me to leave?
No.
Do you want me to stay or not?
I don't. What? Why are you guys like? Why are you so defensive?
You keep telling me to play away, like go away, like play and walk away.
By the way, your grip strength is like just right. I was gonna say Little Red Riding Hood, but what is the porridge girl? No. What is that?
Goldilocks? Sorry, did you legitimately forget?
Yeah.
Goldilocks was.
Yeah, for a second there, I couldn't remember Goldilocks.
Gotcha.
I almost said Rapunzel, but that's the
yeah,
Goldilocks.
No, I mean, you did say Rapunzel.
Yeah, okay.
Like, was
yeah.
You guessing.
But either way, her grip is now just right. Earlier it was really strong, and then barely hanging on to the and now it's fine. Just like that metal porridge and bed, that Goldilocks. So So.
Was it the middle? I thought the middle was Mama Bear.
Well,
the two soft.
I mean, I assumed it was middle because it's just.
Oh,
right.
You don't mean middle in position. You mean middle in like valuation.
No, in my head, I always thought it was portrayed in like in the middle. Like it was the father, the mom, and then the baby, and then the porch boy.
Sorry, you think that it was Papa Bear's bed,
yeah.
Mama Bear's bed, and then their kid just
no.
in the middle?
No, like, Mama Bear, Baby Bear.
Sorry,
that's what I said.
Sorry, bunk beds?
No, like separate beds. But they're they're bigger and smaller, right? So like then Papa Bear's really big.
Yeah.
Mama Bear's, and then Baby Bear's small on this side, and the same for the bowls of porridge. Was there a chair also, or was it just porridge and beds?
Was there? Did they have any other furniture?
Okay, guys, you're
No, you can take your
plates out of the way. Actually, here's your check, and my shift's almost over, so can you guys just sign that, and I'll be right back. Thanks.
See, that service, though, that is not just right. That's the big bed service right there.
Well, you know, I think I might be like Goldilocks. I think I have been looking for porridge that was too soft.
Wait, so.
Sorry! Now I think I'm misremembering what the characteristics were of porridge. Was it that one porridge was too soft? One porridge was too hard?
No.
And one porridge was just right?
No.
Like one bed was super cold?
No, that's the opposite. You've been in your mind, you've inverted the porridge and the bed.
Gosh!
The chairs, I think, may have been sized.
I don't know.
I swear there was more than just.
There was more than just porridge and more than just porridge and beds.
Yeah, I feel like it. Was there like a tub? Did Goldie go to take a bath?
Was there a tub? And you see what? Then there were like three tubs.
Yeah, maybe like one had too much water and like was pouring over, right? And then the little one there was like barely any water, and then the middle water, which I also assumed was the mom's.
Again, it was the mom!
Like the
no,
mom.
It was the baby's stuff that she wanted.
What? I always thought it was the mom's stuff.
No, it was always the baby's thing.
I thought the baby's was the one that was too cold and too soft.
No, the babies were just right. She's a child.
Okay. Weird. Is this one of those, like, Berenstein things? Right, what is that, he was...
So, second date was good. Are you gonna see him again?
I don't know. There was a really weird conversation about Goldilocks, and...
Well, from everything you're telling me, it seems like he wasn't super weird, but he was not just a little bit weird, he was just the right
kind. Yeah, I mean...
Did you do as a difference maker, right?
You know, I'm not gonna lie. I saw things differently.
Yeah.
I think I found the porridge.
Yeah, nice.
And it's just the right temperature.
Or size.
Or size.
Or wetness, as the story goes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Like any spirit, like every 35 years the planets align. What if this doesn't have to be the one time we shut love? What if we could read? What's the opposite of yours of shut? What's like the going back?
Scoot.
Scoot, okay. What if we could scoot in and then shut love again?
I think that has potential. It just, you know, we could talk to Vladimir. He knows all sorts of things about this stuff.
I know, but let's be honest, Vladimir is weird since we both fell in love with you at college.
Well, yeah.
Medieval college.
So.
Look.
Vlad, I don't think you've been able to see on the club.
Look, Vlad, I know you came to me in confidence when we were dealing with catapults and catapult 101. But just, you know, we had a spark, right? We looked at each other and we were talking about the plagues we've had, right? The Spanish Inquisition, and we fell in love, Vlad, and I'm sorry.
Hey, Claudius? You betrayed me.
Look, I don't want to betray you, Vlad. Sorry, I'm just...
It's not hard.
You've been my best friend since we were kids.
Or have I been your best friend?
I didn't mean to hurt you, man. Okay?
Doesn't mean you did anyway.
Yeah, I remember that. He did not take that well.
Didn't take it well. But who else do we know about the occult?
Exactly.
That knows about the occult. Sorry.
I could probably pull some strings with him.
Feels like leading him on, though. That's all. I mean, do we want to break his heart twice?
I mean, we have an eternity to cope with that, and process it, and get over it. So.
Well, wouldn't you put it like that? Yeah. That's, yeah.
Okay, you know, tell you what, I will send the homing pigeon to him. And
which is how they communicate now, yes. In the past.
In the past, yes.
Or as we call it, presence.
Yes, yes. Something we'll call it the past, yeah, because obviously. We are confident that this will work.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, let me find, where did we put that pigeon?
So you, carry any good letters recently?
I don't read them. You read them?
You don't read them?
You know?
Oh, this is juicy stuff these people send to each other. These?
All right, what you got?
Oh. Yeah, let me go get one. I don't deliver all of them. I keep the really juicy ones. Let me go get one.
Oh,
it's in my feet. Yeah, she was nasty.
Turn around. It's a picture.
Man, look at those pigeons up there living the high life. Yeah. Us just being lowly crabs.
Oh, they can go anywhere so fast.
What if we could, like, die and come back as, like, a bird one day? Anyways. Yeah, keep that in my bank.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, you bird.
Yeah! My wing thing.
Yeah.
Vlad.
Yes.
Thank you for showing up.
Hey, what's Vlad?
Hey. I know it's been.
I really had to think it over.
I know it's been 35 years.
Yes, it has been a long 35 years.
Since you didn't show up for our wedding. And which.
Our.
Yes, Ethel is here too.
Hey, it's Carmina. My squid. I mean, my best friend's wife.
Vlad, we just had to have you come. I mean,
yes.
We don't
and I have to have you, sorry?
As smart as you.
And talented.
And handsome.
Good looking, which she already said. A skilled lover, you know.
Well, I don't, you know, don't kiss and tell.
Yeah. I mean,
I also don't kiss.
Yeah. But you know what? You'll get there eventually, you know?
Oh, no. I do everything else.
Oh! Okay.
I don't
he's like, he's weird. Okay. I mean, it's, you know.
So I got one of those dickery guys.
No, I'm good.
But no, we mutually decided that we want you back
yes.
in our lives.
Oh.
Right? Or more for life, you know? And
forever.
If some of us become immortal reoccurring spirits by the end, I mean whatever. You know, we don't want to wait on it. We don't want to wait.
Are you just using me for my knowledge of the dark hour?
What?
I care for you so much.
It depends on the lore, because basically it's like a chimera of different things.
Like what other things?
Sometimes it's a goat, sometimes it's a dragon. Usually there's a lion for sure. Like a lion, and then there's the dark wings, and then like a steamer.
Perfect! I have those down the road. She raises them.
Oh, fantastic! Okay, so that's a keeper. You know what? And this might sound weird, but our kid, before we get virgin hair, right?
Her lock from her first haircut.
Yeah, right?
Perfect.
It's twofer. It's a twofer, right there. So. Yeah, this is so easy. We should have done this a long time ago.
Absolutely.
Hey, Ethel, what do you want?
Hey, Margaret. Have I told you that you're beautiful?
So.
Be quiet, Batman!
Talking about the seed.
Okay, so this five-year-old kid came to me, and they asked if I could use a magic spell to grant three children that were technically under his name. It was crazy. I thought it was a really weird request, but I did it. So that kid, who is still 5 years old, and still totally normal, he just suddenly had three kids in the eyes of the universe.
See, Vlad, that's why we came to you. I just knew that you were the most powerful person that we collectively together knew.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We have all the ingredients.
Yes, finally. Yes. It only took 14 years.
But,
I mean, more. Yeah, on the 9 months. That was 16 years and 3 months.
Yes.
That's how long this quest will take. Anyway,
yeah.
Let me see it. Yeah. So we are ready.
Cool.
To get this possession thing on.
Now, we put in the hair of the grudge. Mm-hmm. And the tail of that lamp pole.
Are you looking for the first one already? Am I really watching the first one already?
No.
Okay, cool. I
care for her deeply. She is my life.
Good.
Sorry, that was. I don't know who that was that went through it. Just
a passionate person. I just that would have been jarring if that was going to walk her into this stupid.
No.
Okay. Anyway, sorry.
Everything is fine. I'm just I felt like it was time.
Yeah.
But like I don't have obviously the second step in the equation, so I had to jump. Right to having the kid.
Okay.
This was the easiest configuration.
Oh, cool. Yeah, we're with you.
Anyway.
I just have to ask, so you can produce children for that 5-year-old. Dude, you gotta have enough respect for yourself to produce one for yourself.
Oh, no. I never self-magicate. It's not safe. Which is why you come to me. You should never self-magicate. Anyway, just going to line this up.
And so, just to be clear, so does the power, does that do it? So, like, are we ready to, like, possess people through the ages?
Well, no, not until you die.
Oh, okay, but...
But you're good.
No further steps are needed.
No, nothing.
So you need the power to... And that's how they became immortal, and Vlad does not know them.
That's
true. No. Yes. What a lovely.
I still want to know how.
Musical stools. Dragon's milk? Well, you milk it. Yeah. And I mean, if
you can milk anything, you can milk this.
Yeah. Well, that's male. That's a misconception.
Yeah.
I don't know how many of you people have milked things, but.
You've milked a dragon?
Not a dragon, but I've milked animals. Alright, and you know, it's not just the nipples. Let's be clear about that. This is not a 9 months thing. Lots of people milk animals. It feels like the crowd is turned against me.
There's children.
It's definitely a family show, but I'm curious where else you milk something.
I've said I've only milked half the female.
We hope. these truths to be self-evident.
Yeah.
That, a lot of people here. Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country.
Four score and 7 years ago.
And then we will go to war. Oh, wow, okay, there's even more of you. Whew, okay, I can do this, I can. Let's just keep this one short, shall we?
Well, Martha, this play has been a regular humdinger. Whew, I can't wait for the second half. I'm just titulated right now.
It's gonna be great.
Yeah, yeah, ooh. So many plot twists. I can't wait to see how this ends. Yeah, yeah.
Yep.
Long intermission, though.
Yes.
Long
intermission. I can't believe you got us kicked out of our earthly bodies in a matter of 10 years.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm not presidential material, okay?
Say that again. Right.
Okay, I'm sorry. All right, you know, we've been at this for a while, Ethel, okay? But you know, there's gonna be some ups and downs, like any immortal relationship.
You know...
Hey! Wait. Did I finish the war?
No.
That was the rest of the play!
It's a bit of a M. Night Shaw kind of thing. There was a twist ending. That is for sure, Mr. President.
Sorry, I'm just kind of blanking a little bit.
Yes. Is this your first time dying? Oh, sorry, I'm
dying. What?
Okay, sorry. Back.
Ah!
Back, okay, sorry.
Ah!
Sorry.
Ah!
All right.
I don't know!
Sorry. Okay, Mr. President.
Yeah.
I'm Hank, this is Ethel.
Hello, I'm Abraham Lincoln. You've what? You've experienced me?
Okay. Cards on the table, we may have possessed you once or twice.
I'm sorry. What?
We may have possessed you when you were alive.
Oh my goodness, is that why I was always blacking out? Wait, did you ever possess my wife?
No.
Oh no, she wasn't crazy, was she?
No.
She just kept getting possessed by you guys. Oh no, my sweet Mary Todd. I'm so sorry, I didn't realize.
But hey, you know what? If you're here, that's a good sign. Because the bad ones, they ride away, you know what I mean? So.
I suppose that is.
Unless it's like a ghost miner that's evil and one day will take up the form of a child. But other than that, all the bad ones right out of there, you know? So.
Well, that's good. That's good. So you guys have been dead long?
Yeah, a while.
We're pros at this.
Yeah.
And you can possess people. Can I possess people?
No, it's a whole thing.
We know that.
You need to die. But you gotta have like firstborns, like manticore bits, you know, dragon's milk is sometimes involved. It's a, you know, which you milk from a female, right? Which
I don't feel comfortable with this topic.
It's a totally normal thing, right?
And I really don't want to discuss it.
Okay, I mean, there's nothing weird about it.
You know? No, there's something definitely weird about talking about this.
Okay, now I feel like you're turning against me, right?
I'm used to people turning against me.
Okay, like the South, or like...
Like a lot of people.
Like, is this a specific, like, is this a John Wilkes thing?
Is that the...
You didn't know?
John Wilkes Booth?
Yeah.
The actor?
Yeah. I mean, not anymore, you know.
Did he retire?
I'm not sure.
I don't know.
Did he go on to do
another stuff?
I think he just died. Yeah, we probably don't know that word about him in the future. Anyway, you know, yeah. So yeah, I don't think he's going to act anymore, if that's any consolation, Mr. President. So.
I'm mean, obviously I'm upset that I'm dead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I won't lie, it's quite a talent.
Yeah.
And it's a shame. Mm-hmm. It's a shame. And also it's like, can I still appreciate, like, the stuff that, like, he did?
Sometimes it's hard to separate.
Even though he did something really bad.
The artist from the art, you know what I mean?
I figure as long as you can appreciate the stuff that they did before you knew they were bad.
Yeah, exactly, right? You can separate the product, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, I mean, you could, like, if you had a picture that, like, I love this picture, and then one day you're like, Adolf painted that, you know, I don't know. Like, you can still.
Who?
Oh, that hasn't happened yet. Sorry.
It's.
Yeah.
Is that one of those,
It's a ghost thing. It's,
oh.
Yeah. Time is non-linear when you're beyond the veil.
You'll learn.
We should fight them on the beaches! We're really gonna fight them on the beaches! We'll fight them on the shores! You're the concern! No one wasn't proud of the speech! No, should that continue? I'm just trying to say no, please, really! No, you're making a mockery of this nation! You're speaking way too loud! You're just screaming out of power! You're yelling in my ear! It's making it difficult for me to whisper to you! Plus, it's painful! I want to get out of this speech, but you just need to stop whispering what I'm saying to you. Okay, because the audience can see what I'm doing. All right, I'm not in front, I'm facing the back. Oh, that would just a performance piece. Sure, it's not ideal. Okay, so let's just start over. Okay, so we'll fight them on the beach. Fight them on the shores! You are so loud! Like, legitimately, this is hurting my ears right now! Like, I feel like I'm gonna have tinnitus! How can you get tinnitus, Steve?
It's like,
is it a one-time thing, or is that, like, build-up over time? Like, accumulative? Is that one bad event? Or is it a series of steps? Right?
Is it a fall or an escalator?
What's an escalator?
So an escalator!
Thank you everyone for joining us for the Moral Unitarian Union. We want to thank Elizabeth for hosting us. We couldn't do this without her, and you know, for providing popcorn. We want to thank you guys for coming, because we can't also do this without you. Our next show is next month on the 26th. It is a Saturday.
Yep.
And also, this coming Saturday, a number of us will be playing with the So You Comedy Group here at the Dixie Center.
The Dixie Convention Center.
That is also true.
Not this coming, not tomorrow.
That is correct, yes.
The next one.
I don't count.
We think tomorrow is too soon.
Yes, yes.
And we think two, and we think three Saturdays from now
too
is
soft.
Too many.
Yes.
Too soft Saturdays.
Yeah. So, the following Saturday.